I'm going to miss you.
It's crazy how, like, you're 1 month pregnant and you're already like this.
Go away.
It's just 1 week.
Welcome to Iran.
Are you here for business or pleasure?
I'm a journalist. I'm covering the elections for Newsweek magazine.
Tensions are rising in Iran.
The election has ended in controversy.
What are you doing? Fighting back! You're gonna get killed, come on!
You have a real weapon and you choose not to use it.
Stand up. We are here now.
Sir, can you tell me why I'm here?
That's what happened to foreign spies caught on Iranian soil.
We all know Jon Stewart from what we see on television. We don't all know him personally, obviously. But boy, did he ever do a fantastic job directing this film. What impressed you when you began to work with him about him?
Well, this thing of, I mean, he's unlike any other first-time director, you know. He just goes for it in a way that, I mean, he's been working for 20 years or something in his show. So he has a, he's used to work with many people, you know, to put together a group and solve things last minute and improvise and, you know, so. Mm-hmm. I mean, he's a good team leader, but at the same time, he had a point of view. I mean, he has a point of view of what he wanted to achieve or where he wanted to kind of explore, and he would gather a group of people that would help him interpret that point of view and help him experiment that, and that's what ended up happening. And he's got that interesting angle as well, that he's a person that makes you feel very comfortable, that is very fun, that is very intelligent, that is very loving as well. So you would fall into a good place so as to just let go and do the thing, you know? I'm sure that the next projects that he has in mind or whatever he wants to do, it's gonna be good, because he's such a nice guy. I mean, he's such an intelligent, I mean, he's one of the smartest and quickest people I've ever known.
You must not just take his blood. You must take his hope.
Your wife will never see you again. Your child will never know you.
Fight, Ozzy. Use your freedom. Use their weakness.
John is very humble as well, and he wanted to. He found the story and the point of view he wanted to put across was inspired and was first and foremost from Maziar's point of view of his experience. Mm-hmm. I mean, when he wrote this book called And Then They Came For Me, there is a caustic humor there that John found really, really interesting, because who would find that light in that deprivation, you know? When one is put into that situation of solitary confinement, being accused of of doing something that you're clearly not even close to being, Maziar found a sense of humor in that, and in a very poetic way, he manifested the ridiculousness that it always is.
Yes.
This persecution is always a comedy. This, I mean, Kafka has, and Dostoevsky, and I mean, there's, in literature it's been put across many times, but in film it's rarely seen, and especially nowadays. So John really grabbed onto something very important, and Maziar is the same description I would give to about John. I mean, Maziar is a lovely, intelligent, fun, easygoing person, mm-hmm. and Maziar has this thing of being a triumph of the human spirit, I think, because he came out of there finding himself with a lot of strength to fight for the right of people of bearing witness all over the world, but also pointing out an interesting, quite dangerous issue, which is that solitary confinement is torture, and that is completely accepted in even the most sophisticated democracies.
What are you doing?
They locked you up, but you're still free.
In their hearts, they know they cannot win.